Hello and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, I'll explain Toda Yamamoto approach to Granger-Nahn causality in time series. I'll discuss this in two different ways. First, I will explain its theory, some of the basic steps involved in performing Toda Yamamoto test, and then I will use time series to test for Granger-Nahn causality. So let me start with the introduction to Toda Yamamoto test. How to perform Toda Yamamoto or TY test for Granger-Nahn causality in EVs. Toda Yamamoto test is an alternative to ordinary Granger causality test, which is based on a modified version of Granger-Nahn causality test. This test was first used by Toda Yamamoto in their 1995 paper in order to overcome the shortcomings in the conventional Granger causality test. TY test uses an augmented SVAR K plus D max, which generates asymptotic VAR statistics in the form of chi-square distribution. K is the optimal leg length of the time series, and D max is the maximum order of integration. Let me remind you a very simple definition of Granger causality. Let us assume there are two time series variable. One is X, where X stands for consumption, and Y stands for GDP. And then I can say X is said to Granger cause Y if the future values of Y can be better predicted using the past values of both X and Y, then it can be predicted by using the past values of Y alone. Consider this definition again. You must think on it. You must understand it. X is said to Granger cause Y if the future values of Y can better predict using past values of both X and Y series, then it can by using only the past values of Y. Granger-Nahn causality test can be estimated by the following VAR model. There are two equations. Y equation is equal to alpha naught plus alpha 1 yt minus 1 up to alpha p yt minus p plus theta 1 xt minus 1 up to theta p xt minus p plus innovation. Similarly, x equation is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 xt minus 1 up to beta p xt minus p plus gamma 1 yt minus 1 up to gamma p yt minus p plus another innovation vt. Now, if you test the hypothesis, alternative hypothesis theta 1 is equal theta 2 is equal to up to theta p is equal to 0 against alternative hypothesis that the null is not true is a test that X does not Granger cause Y. And similarly, testing H naught gamma 1 is equal to gamma 2 up to gamma p is equal to 0 against the alternative that the null is not true is a test that Y does not Granger cause X. Now, there are some basic steps involved in Toda Yamamoto procedure. First of all, we must determine the maximum order of integration of the time series. And the other important thing is that it is very important to know the actual order of integration. And for that, it is important that we have a cross-check when we test for stationarity using augmented Dickey Fuller test and KPSS test. So both the tests are the mirror opposite of each other regarding the null hypothesis. In augmented Dickey Fuller test, the null hypothesis is that the time series has a unit root, that is, it is non-stationary. And its alternative hypothesis is that it is stationary, whereas in KPSS, the null hypothesis is that the series is stationary, it doesn't have a unit root, and its alternative is that it is not stationary. So we must have a cross check using both these criteria to check for order of integration. And when we determine the maximum order of integration, if x is integrated of order 0 and y is integrated of order 1, then the maximum order of integration is 1. If x is integrated of order 1 and y is integrated of order 2, then the maximum order of integration is 2. After this, once we determine the maximum order of integration, then we set up a war model at the level of the data, regardless of the order of integration of the various time series, and we don't difference the data, no matter what did we find regarding the stationarity check. Then we will decide upon the optimal leg length for the time series variables in the war, and say that the optimal leg length is p, using the usual method, say Akaike information criteria or Schwarz information criteria or any other criteria for checking the leg length. We must be sure that there is no serial correlation in the residuals. In case if there are correlation, if there is serial correlation in the residuals, in that case we must increase the leg length until there are no issues of autocorrelation in the model. If two or more of the time series have the same order of integration, then we must test to see if they are integrated, preferably using Johansson approach. And no matter what we conclude about the co-integration, this is not going to affect what follows. It just provides a possible cross-check on the validity of our results at the very end of the analysis. So then we will use our suggested war model, and we will add in m additional legs of each of the variables in each equation on y and x. In order to test Granger non-causality, we assume that the war has two equations, one for x and y, one for y. And then we test the hypothesis that the coefficients of all the leg value we test the hypothesis that the coefficients of all the lagged values of x are 0 in the y equation using the standard Wald test. And we will repeat the same thing for the coefficients of the lagged values of y in the x equation. It is important that we don't include the coefficients for the extra m legs when we perform the Wald test, because they are there only to fix up the asymptotics. The Wald test statistics will be asymptotically chi-square distributed with p degrees of freedom under the null hypothesis. If you reject the null hypothesis, it implies a rejection of the Granger non-causality. It means a rejection of the null hypothesis supports the presence of Granger causality. Finally, we must look at what we concluded about co-integration. If two or more time series are co-integrated, then there must be Granger causality between them, either one way or in both directions. However, converse is not true, meaning that if there is causality between the series, they may not necessarily be co-integrated. So, if our data are co-integrated, but we don't find any evidence of causality, we have a conflict in our results, and then we must be worried. If we have co-integration and we find one-way causality, then everything is fine. If our data are not co-integrated, then we have no cross-check on our causality results. This is a brief introduction and a procedure or basic steps involved in performing Toda Yamamoto test for Granger non-causality. Thanks very much for watching this video. Kindly subscribe to the channel. The name of the channel in YouTube is Research Made Easy with Himi Khan. Now I will open my work file in eViews and I will follow the procedure that I just discussed, and finally I will discuss my results. This is my work file in which there are a number of time series. This is a quarterly data starting from 1947 quarter 1 up to 1989 quarter 4. So the total number of observations is 172. Just for the sake of simplicity, let us suppose I want to use Toda Yamamoto test involving two series. One is X is consumption, and one is Y means GNP. Let me open these two series as group. These are my series. So first of all, I will determine the maximum order of integration. In order to save my time, I have already checked the unit root in both these series, and according to both augmented Dickey Fuller test and KPSS test, I found out that both the series are integrated of order 1. They are non-stationary at level, but they are stationary when I difference this data. So they are stationary, they are integrated of order 1. So the maximum order is, the maximum order of integration is 1. Now I will specify the optimal leg length. For that, first of all, I will go to estimate var, and here I will write the name of my series GNP, and I will not change anything. I will press OK, and these are my results. Now I will go to optimal leg length to leg structure, and menu to go to leg length criteria. When I click on this, let me write 12 as my legs, and I get this table, and this is a var leg order selection criteria. My endogenous variables are consumption and GNP. Exogenous variable I is constant. This is date of performing this analysis, 17th of April 2019, and the time is 6:35 p.m. And this is the sample, and these are included observations, 153. Now, if I look at these figures, there are a number of streaks here under this criteria, under Ekaike information criteria, and under Schwarz criteria and Hanan and Quinn criteria. These asterisks shows that the optimal leg length is 2. But one criteria, LR is sequential modified LR test statistic, and it shows that the optimal leg length is 11. Let us suppose I use a 2, because this is a democracy rule. 4 criteria show that the optimal leg length is 2. Now let me estimate var model in GNP, and let me use these two criteria. And let me press OK, and here is the model. But let me check its you must be very careful about the autocorrelation. If there is a serial correlation in this model, then the war is not the best fit. So let me check it. When I use a 2 legs, this is this is the LM state, and these are the probability value at leg 1. The value of LM state is 6.53, and its p value is insignificant. It is insignificant, but it is not, it is significant at leg 4. Let me increase the number of legs from 2, Cn, Gnp, let me make it 5. I have checked it before, at 5, it gives a good results. And here is my model, and now let me check its residual test, and this is a correlation test. The results are much improved now, so I can use this. But let me also cross check the absence of serial correlation, that is no serial correlation, checking its AR roots table, and it says at least one root outside the unit circle, so this model is not stable. Let me also check the graph, of this model. So yes, at least one root is outside the unity circle. So my dear students, we must play with the model, and we must increase the number of legs till the problem of autocorrelation is resolved. Let me go to quick again and increase the number of legs Cn, Gnp up to 11. You remember one of the criteria was giving us this. Now let me see what happens. Here is the output. Now let me go to see the AR roots table, and it still says that at least one root lies outside the unit circle. What about the autocorrelation? Well, not bad. So now let me estimate the model again and test for Toda Yamamoto Cn Gnp. Let me use this was the best of all. And here, as I told you, that we will use m additional legs. So I'm using 5 legs, optimal legs, and here I will use Cn minus 6 and Gnp minus 6. Now my estimated war model is here. Now this time, if you look at this model, there are 5 legs for the consumption, and there will be 5 legs for the Gnp, and then there is a constant, and these are the additional legs, one for consumption and one for Gnp. Now let me test. Let me first check the AR table. And now it says that no root lies outside the unit circle, and VAR satisfies the stability condition. Now our VAR model is stable. Similarly, let me check it AR roots graph, and now the VAR model is stable. All the roots lie inside the unit circle. So using Toda Yamamoto in our VAR model, now it makes the model stable. Let me check now let me use it for Granger non-causality, and this is my test. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look here, this is VAR Granger causality block exogeneity VAR test. this is the date on which this analysis is performed. This is the time. The time is now 18:42, or you can say 6:42 minutes. And this is sample from 1947 quarter 1 till 1989 quarter 4. The number of included observations is 159. Now this is the model when consumption is the dependent variable and GNP is the independent variable. Now this means the null hypothesis that GNP doesn't Granger cause CN. But if you look at the probability value of this chi-square test, then we fail to reject the null hypothesis of no Granger causality from GNP to CN. Okay, so we cannot reject the null hypothesis of no Granger cause. Coming to the second equation of y, that is GNP. Now here the null hypothesis is that consumption does not Granger cause GNP, and its chi square value is 30.029, its p value is 0.0000. So we strongly reject the null hypothesis of no Granger causality from CN to GNP. So we conclude that consumption Granger cause GNP, that is the past values of consumption variable better predict the future value of GNP. So this is how we perform Toda-Yamamoto test to test for Granger non-causality between these series. We can perform this test for more than two series, but just for the sake of convenience, I only used two series, one for consumption and one for GNP. So if you have any question, kindly do ask. Share this video with your students, with your colleagues, with your friends, so that they can also get benefit from this video. And I would like you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet subscribed, and kindly do not forget to click on icon bell so that you can get notification about my other videos in future. I'm very grateful to you, and have a good afternoon. Thank you.